The output of the chi-square test of independence in R usually consists of three parts: the test itself, and in the case of a significant test result, the effect size omega and post-hoc tests. You might also add the contingency table for further reference. First, one formulates which variables have been tested for independence. Next, you can state whether the observed and the expected counts are similar or different. Or put another way, if there is some sort of relation and if it is significant or not. For the purpose of significance, the chi-square value is reported together with the number of degrees of freedom and the sample size. In this test, the degrees of freedom is always the number of rows minus 1 multiplied with the number of columns minus 1 of your contingency table. This is followed by the p-value. In the case of a significant difference, i.e. effect, you can report the effect size Cohen's omega, or sometimes also referred to as Cohen's w. The magnitude of this effect is classified with, for example, Cohen 92, or the respective research field specific thresholds. It is also recommended to do post-hoc tests and state which cell of your contingency table showed a significant difference of actual and expected count under the assumption of independence.